Hey everyone, especially to my daughter Eden and my son Uriah. My wife, here's an update of what's been going on. Actually, it's not an update, it's from 2 days ago. I just don't have time to, no, I do have time to do the footage, but you know me, I end up talking to people and socializing. And then it goes to the back burner. You can hear my voice now, it's starting to get hoarse. I've got to last for another 3 days, 4 days. But, it's 7 o'clock in the morning on Wednesday, and man, having a blast, eh? Having a real blast. It's I remember everyone Hoopla talking about Superman syndrome for the ministers, and I'm starting to get that. You know, the more I hang out with the teens and they tell me the situation and those are things they're going through, and then I realize, man, it's raw. You know, like the stuff they're going through with family. Broken families, frustrations, parents suffering from chronic diseases, and you know, asking what's fair. You know, like, man, I tell you what. I'm talking to my ministering friends. All those doctrines that we understand, those precious, awesome understanding of prophecy and that, which is. You know, I mean, Daniel 9:25 is the reason why I believe Jesus is Jesus. But man, when you're facing these kids one to one, and they're giving you this raw information, that's the last thing to hear, man. I tell you what, the other night when I talked about Jesus as a warrior, I told the story of Abraham Lot, and I just honed in on the fact that, you know, don't forget that. Jesus is also the one that holds the sword. You know, with Joshua, he's the commander of the army. He's the one that led the angels to beat Lucifer and his angels. He's the same one that killed 185,000 Assyrians in one swift movement, man. This is the Jesus that we have. And man, when I preached about that the other night, man, these kids lapped it up, man. They need to hear that. They need to understand. That Jesus does this, you know, he fights on our behalf. And yeah, to be honest, that's probably my favorite part to study about Jesus, the fact that he fights for us, man. I like Jesus the fighter. Anyone that knows me probably knows that too. But you know, I mean, the many times that he's done it in my life, for my wife, for our kids, man, when he fights for us, man, knockout every time, man. That guy leaving an awesome record. But these kids needed to hear that, you know. I didn't talk too much about. I mean, I told them that one of the most unique doctrines of the Adventists is Jesus is Michael, and this is why. Bang, man. And last night, high priest, and I just helped them understand that Jesus understands everything about us. And the slogan last night was, he knows us, he knows me better than I know me. And, whew, man, Hebrews 4:15-16, just honed in on that. He understands everything and looked at Jesus' history and his family, you know. Two prostitutes, a Moabite woman, and a woman that got forced by David to sleep with him and then end up killing the husband because of it. So Jesus understands messed up families. So I made a call for it. These kids responded instantly. Five of them just came up straight away. You know, they understood and they felt the call. They need to release that anger and bitterness and frustrations, man. Praise the Lord. But thank you for your prayers, man. I'm learning every night myself. And it's a big work, man. You know, something I realized too, just preaching last night, something that came to mind as I was talking was, you know, for my mum and dad, messed up families kind of stopped with them because I'm pretty sure in the past, in my history, coming from Samoa, you know, especially with this Moikolo stuff, you know, I'm pretty sure that there were some people that didn't consent to being a mother. And, Yeah, I'm sure my history is riddled with that, but I realized that the whole change of these type of situation starts with you. And I was telling that to the teens, it starts with them. You know, the bitterness and the anger stops with them. You know, when they meet the right partner, and man, that's something they really like talking about. One of the young people told me that I'm the first speaker in the teens to actually use the word sex. And last night I even got into the word porn, because it comes up in the questions that the kids ask me from the front. So, you know, if they ask you, you got to be straight up, right? And I'm not afraid to talk about it. It's real. And they got mobile phones and stuff like that. And man, you know, when they find the right partner, man, they can make powerful couples, and make powerful ministries and powerful examples and powerful role models. Oh, anyway, here's some footage. I'm starting to preach, but I'm having a good time. Love you, Donnie. Hope you enjoy the video. Bye.